Well, Friday night is oftentimes a date night here in downtown Toronto. Couples getting together, getting to know each other, likes and dislikes. But others are skipping several steps and just moving in right with each other. Karen has called this basement apartment home for the last 2 years. Now she's taking a stab at being a homeowner, but she's not doing it alone.
One of my friends is currently a homeowner, and her and I are looking to purchase a house together.
Co-ownership gives the opportunity for Karen and her friend to pull their financial resources together to fulfill a lifelong dream many Torontonians have, buying a home in a red-hot housing market.
This was sort of like just a dream for us. It wasn't something that we had really anticipated maybe coming to fruition. What we're looking to do is have two separate living spaces and sort of have a door in between that we can open and close so that we still get privacy, but we get kind of all the perks of having a large house too.
How common is co-ownership?
It's becoming more and more common.
Realtor Leslie Gaynor has taken notice of the growing interest in non-traditional ownership, referred to as the best kept real estate secret in Toronto. And not only does it offer economic benefits, Gaynor says it also has social perks.
I think it is a concept that has not necessarily been embraced by the real estate industry.
Why is that?
I think there are many reasons. I think it's complicated.
But while Karen is taking this leap with a close friend, Gaynor has also been playing matchmaker. She recently played host to a speed dating-like event to introduce like-minded individuals interested in co-ownership.
It helps us change our dialogue about what we need in the way of housing, what we need in the way of getting into an insane market, what might be easier if we jointly put our resources together and shared some of the things that we have in our back pockets.
But this process isn't so black and white. There are challenges in co-ownership.
Both of us are feeling really anxious. It's a huge decision.
The merging of two personalities, two lives, and two visions can sometimes differ. So Gaynor suggests legally protecting yourself.
Like any relationship, you have to be prepared for the pitfalls. Are you able to negotiate well with a strong legal agreement, but can you work some of the smaller stuff out?
Now, Gaynor advises her clients to have at least a 5-year commitment or term if they do plan on co-ownership, and she is planning on a second speed meeting session.